Assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome back to another session of math. Today's lesson we will discuss 7.1, which is permutations and combinations. Learning intentions. We will be solving problems involving fundamental counting principle. And after that we will go for problem solving involving permutation and combination. So let's have a look at what is this fundamental counting principle mean. First of all, it says counting. So this is something about counting. We do count, yeah, using our fingers when it is large enough, we can't. So let's have a look at what is this principle says and how it's going to help us. For example, you have something on here and you are thinking how many different ways you can arrange this one. So this counting principle will help you a lot in that. It says that if something can be done in m ways, you can pause the video and read it, and something else can be done in n different ways, then the whole can be done in m times n. You just multiply, then you get the total number of arrangements or whatever you are going to count. Maybe this example will help you. You are going to make some dessert. And you have choices like flavor, fruit, nuts. And you are asked to, or you are interested to know how many different ways I can make this dessert. For example, I can choose vanilla, peaches and walnuts. Or I can go for vanilla, raspberries and almonds. So how many different ways? Do I have to really count them like how we do? Really no. We can see how many different ways one thing can happen, how many the other, and you just multiply. So flavors 2, fruits 5, and nuts 3, you just multiply them and you get a number 30. This means you can have 30 different choices to make this dessert. And I have this many and this, usually and will give you a multiplication in math. Another thing which we need to know in this lesson is factorial. By the way, factorial is only a symbol to show some multiplication. There is the definition. You can pause the video and read it. This example will help you a lot. Factorial 5. This is the way we read. See, this is the symbol for factorial. What does this mean? It's simple. You start from 5 and count down until 1. You multiply all of them. It's 120. Factorial 9 is start from which number? 9, 8, 7, and go until 1, count down, multiply them, you get number 360, 2880. This is factorial 9. This is just for your knowledge, and we will see how we gonna use the symbol in counting procedure. Let's begin with to know what does this permutations and combination really mean? I will break this one to your known language. Permutation is nothing but arrangement. Combination is grouping. Let's have an example. See, you have three different marbles or different balls. How many different ways you can arrange this one? As I told you, the whole lesson is about counting and arranging. You can see in here, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different ways. Counting principle will help you for this. How? You just give 1, 2, 3 spaces because this one's first place, second and third. How many different ways you can choose this box? You can either give red or blue or green. You have three choices. Once you fix this one, you have only two choices to make. Once you fix these two, you have only one ball to remain to you as your choice. And you just multiply them. That is what counting principle says. And you have 6. So you don't have to count like this. You just need to see 3 marbles. Okay, then 3 times 2 times 1. Or 3 marbles is factorial 3. If you really remember how we use the notation for the factorial. So we have 6 different permutations. And see the combination, the group. How many group is this one? I have a red, green, blue, or I have blue, red, green, doesn't matter for me. So if order doesn't matter, we say it's a group or combination. How many combinations for this one is? One. So when you have red one, you have only one ball. How many different ways you can arrange is one, and this table will help you to know how many different ways. Okay, this is the permutation. How many different arrangement you can make. If you have seven things with you in hand, how many different ways you see? You can do it in 5,040 different ways of arranging. Pretty good, yeah? But now, the actual lesson. You look at that symbol, this symbol as well. You see, sometimes you don't have to arrange all the three like we did before. I'm choosing now two at a time. So I have to take only two at a time. And I will see how many different arrangements. And I will see how many different combinations. You can pause the video and count this one. And you have six different arrangements when you are taken two at a time. And we write symbolically 3P2. 3 with P2. Permutation. P for permutation or picking up. Okay? Or arrangement. And this one is, why it is only 3 in the group? Because AB and BA, if I have blue and red, or red and blue, my group is the same. So I have only 3 groups. So what is the number of combination? 3. 3C2. Or we say this 3C2 means you have 3 things, 2 taken at a time, where the order matters, the grouping. So don't you think you need a formula to calculate this one? You can't see by arranging every time if the numbers are so large. Look at the formula is. If you want to count how many permutation, how many arrangement, you have this formula and you know pretty well what is this factorial notation mean. And combination, how many combination you have factorial n and n minus r, but you divide with r factorial. You will have always less number of combination than permutation. See, you need to divide the replica because A, B and B are the same as usual as the previous slide shows. Let's have some examples, okay? Suppose that you want to select and order 3 people from a group of 7. 7 people are there, but you have only 3 chairs to sit. You are arranging 7 people, 3 taken at a time. Okay, so these numbers are important now, 7 and 3. Is it order matter here or not? If they say there are 7 people you are choosing, 3 of them in order. You have to choose in order. So, somebody sitting here, A sits here, B sits here, C sits the other, or B sits, it's different. Order matters. So, we use the formula, permutation formula, and you can see formula is here. What is N? N is the whole number. 7 people are there. How many are taken at a time as a sample? 3 people. So it is 7P3, and you can very well see how we do. Factorial 7 means from 7 you need to count down until 1. And 7 minus 3 is 4 factorial. So you need to do from 4. And you can see that 210 different arrangements is possible with this 7 people. And when you have 3 chairs only to sit. Something, again, interesting. Now you have how many ways can, you can pause the video and look at, is it a question for permutation or combination? It is permutation because it's about arranging. Okay? Because you need to display that. You have to display how many different ways. Another one, you can see the, pause the video and read it. I'm just showing some examples so that you won't get confused. Even though you know the formula, you must be very clear about is it permutation or combination. So you have to see the first thing. Is order matters? See the question. You are choosing out from the 11 kittens, you are choosing 3 kittens. Okay, is order matter? Doesn't matter, I choose these 3. Or I choose from this and or, no, it doesn't matter. This A, B, C or B, C, A are the same. So it's about combination. So the whole thing depend upon this question. Is the order matters? Yes, then you use the permutation. It doesn't matter. You use the combination. It doesn't matter. So it's about a combination. Again, another example. You have the password. Don't you think the password order matters or not? Of course, definitely, you know very well. It matters. So it is about permutation. Okay? And from where did I get 10? Because there are 10 different digits here. And from where I get 4? Because you can fill in 4. So this is 10, 4 taken at a time. This is the way we say, taken at a time, or 4 in 4 groups. And you can see this, try your own question. Something amazing. This number goes like 5,760,000. Such a big number. You can do it. And the happy news is you can do it in the calculator, okay? You can make it in the calculator and check with that question. Now this is the summary of the lesson. You can read the summary. Hope you enjoy the lesson. So as a whole, you can see that the whole lesson is about counting and arranging. So you have to choose the question properly. Is it about the arranging with order, or are you arranging or selecting without order? So you have something, clue words. This clue words will be there, but still, understanding of the question is very important. If the order is order matters, then you have to see, you wanted to take the formula of permutation, or this one is combination. Also, you can use your counting principle, which we start from the beginning. I will come up with some more questions. You can also find some questions on your YouTube. Then these two facts. Try to remember NP0 is 1 and N0 is 1. That's all about the lesson.